Thanks for joining us here on World Tech Update. I'm Nick Barber. We'll start in Shenzhen, China, with Intel's Developer Forum. CEO Brian Krzanich showed off a slimmed-down version of the company's RealSense 3D camera.
But what I want to show you now for the first time in public is the new RealSense camera that we're implementing into systems this year. And what you see when I hold them up next to each other is it's about half the size as the previous version. And if you could see in thickness, it's probably less than half the thickness as well.
RealSense cameras were scheduled to go into just tablets and laptops, but now with the smaller size, smartphones are on the list. The RealSense 3D cameras can sense depth much like a Microsoft Kinect sensor. That means you could control applications on your phone with gestures or take a 3D scan of objects, among other things. Intel also showed off what it calls the world's smallest PC. About the size of a flash drive, the compute stick will cost $150 with Windows and $110 with Linux. It has an Intel Atom quad-core processor, 2 gigs of RAM, and 32 gigs of storage. It plugs into a monitor or TV via HDMI. Look out, iPhone 6 Plus. China's ZTE is on your heels with a high-end phablet of its own, the Nubia Z9 Max. The Android phone will first come to China for 2,500 yuan or $408, but ZTE plans to bring it to North America, Europe, and emerging markets later. The phone has a 5.5-inch 1080p screen and Qualcomm's new Snapdragon 810 octa-core processor at 2 GHz. It has slots for dual SIM cards, which is useful in both developed and emerging markets where multiple operators might be used. The camera on the phone includes manual control of the aperture, ISO, and white balance, features that more advanced photographers will appreciate. You've seen it here on World Tech Update before. Apple has a new product, and people line up outside stores and even sleep overnight waiting for it. Apple says, stop doing that. In a memo, Apple's SVP of retail and online stores instructed employees to tell customers interested in the watch or MacBook to order the products online instead of from stores. Inventory issues have complicated previous Apple product launches, most recently with the iPhone 6, which went on sale in September. The memo implies that Apple isn't keen on product shortages and sees online sales as a way to prevent customers from leaving its stores empty-handed. A new survey has debunked the myth that Facebook is losing its cool factor among teenagers. Facebook is the most popular social network among teens, according to a survey published by the Pew Research Center. The researchers found that 71% of all teens use it, and 41% of teens said they use Facebook the most often compared to other sites. YouTube is planning a paid service that will let viewers watch select videos without ads. Google confirmed it in a letter sent to members of YouTube's partner program, which lets YouTube video makers earn money from ads and merchandise. It's not clear when the new service will launch, nor the price, or what it will be called. YouTube will pay video creators using the service 55% of the total net revenues from subscription fees. The changes go into effect on June 15th. More auto news this week from New York with Jaguar's impressive touchscreen dashboard. The 2016 XF will come standard with an 8-inch touchscreen infotainment and navigation setup, but will also have an optional all-new 10.2-inch system. The large screen version features an Intel quad-core processor. In addition, the XF features a 12.3-inch digital instrument cluster with full-screen navigation. The Pro system allocates 10 gigs of its 60-gig SSD to media storage, features improved natural language voice command, and can be equipped with a 17-speaker, 825-watt digital surround sound system. Pricing hasn't been announced for this year's model, but last year's cost up to $100,000. The first 3D printed objects in space are back on the ground and are being compared to the same ones printed here on Earth. NASA wanted to see the difference 3D printing in zero gravity would have on the final products. The objects were all printed on the International Space Station, which is orbiting the Earth about 200 miles up. As NASA aims to reach Mars in the 2030s, 3D printing will be an important way for astronauts to fashion replacement parts or tools millions of miles away from Earth. Well, that's our show for this week. Thanks for joining us here on World Tech Update. Next week, we'll have some coverage for you from NAB in Las Vegas. As we head out, we'll leave you with some shots of the Volvo Ocean Race. I'm Nick Barber, and for all of us here at the IDG News Service, thanks for watching, and we hope to see you next week.